Father God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, we love you this morning, Jesus. Lord, we come under the unction of the Holy Ghost, Lord God. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for our mother, Lord God. Thank you for your only begotten son, Jesus, Lord God. Lord, as I come and ask you, Lord God, to move on out of the way, Lord God. Hide me, Lord God, behind the cross, Lord God. That your people may see you, God, and glorify you, God. It's not about me this morning, Lord God, but it's all about you, Jesus. Lord, as I come, oh God. Lord, I need your strength and your mercy, Lord God. Lord, I can't deliver your word without you, Jesus. Holy Ghost, when I open my mouth, you preach for me. And when I sit down, I will give you the honor, glory, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. The minister read the scripture from Matthew, the 12th chapter, from the 46th verse to the 50th. And my text coming from the 50th verse. For whosoever shall do the will of my heavenly Father which is in heaven, the same is my brother and my sister and my mother. Yeah. My text this morning would be the will of my heavenly Father. Yeah. You know, God created all of us in his own image. Yeah. He created us for a purpose. Yeah. And that purpose is to do his will. See, I don't know what your will is this morning, yeah. But my will is to preach the good new gospel of Jesus Christ. Yeah. My will is to pray for my sister and brother. Yeah. And my will is to love one another, yeah, as Christ has loved me. Yeah. And as I studied this lesson, I began to look over my life. When I was out there in the world, I knew what my will was. Yeah. But I was out there doing the will of the devil. Hallelujah. Yeah. Doing the will of the devil. Could have been dead a long time ago. Yeah. But I thank God for mother. For mother praying for me. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Jesus, when this passage of the scripture, Jesus didn't disown his mother, his sisters, and his brother. He wanted them to know about not only a physical relationship, but a spiritual relationship as well. And Jesus, he had a spiritual relationship with his Heavenly Father, Jehovah God, and an earthly relationship with his mother Mary and his father Joseph. And Mary, she was a virgin. She was a young Jewish girl. And she was engaged to Joseph, but she wasn't married. And God found favor in Mary. You know, Mary, she was humble. She was beautiful. And God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth. And Gabriel appeared unto Mary and told Mary, well, that God had found favor in her, yeah, and that she was highly favored and that she was blessed among women. Yeah. Are you blessed this morning, women? Yeah. Mothers, are you blessed this morning? Hallelujah. Yeah. And the angel appeared to Mary and said, Mary, that it conceived in that womb, thou shalt name his name Jesus, and he shall save his people from their sin. Yeah. And Mary asked the angel, said, how could it be that I knew not a man? Yeah. And the angel Gabriel told Mary, the Holy Ghost, yeah, shall come upon thee, yeah, and the power from the Most High shall overshadow thee, yeah, and thou shalt bear a son. This is a supernatural death. I mean, supernatural birth. A miraculous birth. Can nobody do but God. Yeah. Nobody but God. Yeah. And Mary, she was a willing vessel. And she accepted the will of the Lord. Yeah. And she carried her son Jesus in her womb for 9 months. Because she knew that she had heard and heard from the Almighty God.
Yeah.
And as Mary went through her birth with Jesus, she always had these things pondered in her heart what the angel told her. And when she birthed Jesus, she went into the temple. And Simeon was there, and she gave her baby to Simeon. She gave her baby back to the Lord. That's just like some of us. When we birth our child, we need to give them back to the Lord. Because it's a blessing when you give your child back to the Lord.
Yeah.
You'll feel much better. You'll feel that your child is protected, yeah, because he's in the hands of the Almighty God. And as Jesus went on through on 33 years on earth, Jesus did the will of his heavenly Father. Jesus went about healing the blind, laying hands on the sick, and they was healed. Jesus even delivered Mary Magdalene from seven demons. He even healed Peter's mother-in-law because he was about his Father's business. Because he knew he had to accomplish his purpose while he was on earth. See, Jesus was human and divine. Jesus had two natures. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. He was divine from his heavenly Father. And he had an earthly nature from his earthly mother, Mary. And as Mary fathered Jesus all through his life on earth, seeing her son humiliated, heard about the people. But she was all through, she was step by step with her son. Now I want to let the parents know, the young parents, the mother, don't give up on your child. Hallelujah. Yeah. Because Jesus didn't give up on us. Yeah. In spite of our mess, Jesus was still there to forgive us.
Yeah.
In my younger age, I had three children out of wedlock. But I wanted me a husband. And I thought one was going to be my husband. But that wasn't the will of the Lord. But as I began to seek the Holy Ghost, started reading the Word of God, studying the Word of God, I got tired of these boyfriends. Hallelujah. Tired of using a broom. Hallelujah. Tired of fornicating. I got tired. My soul got weary. And one night I fell on my knees. I said, Lord, have mercy. Please, Lord. And at the time, I was going with Deacon Wilson, but we wasn't married. He was my boyfriend then. And I remember, Mother God, I used to come to church every Sunday. And I always would sit right there by you. Hallelujah. And one Sunday morning, Pastor DeLord, he was standing up here preaching. And like he was talking directly at me. I was singing in the choir. I was just singing. Just singing. And living any kind of way I wanted, little shaky. And Reverend Lord stood here on the pulpit. And he come from Corinthians. And he said, the word said, flee from fornication. Hallelujah. Looked like something just pierced me. And I felt that word. And he was my boyfriend at the time. And I said, I can't do it no more. I can't. And so I had to keep seeking God for an answer. And I asked God a question. I told God, if he for me, let him be. If he's not moving out the way, hallelujah. Because I wanted me a husband. Hallelujah. I can understand what some people say, if he'll marry, he'll put a ring on your finger. That's true too. But I come to tell you this morning, before he put that ring on your finger, you be the heard from God, know that that is your husband. Because some of us get married, we be unequally yoked. And it doesn't be our husband. And all times went on and on, I began to get a house bill. And I told my husband, I can't go in my house sinning because the God has blessed me and I didn't want to mess up my blessing. How many know God don't dwell in no unclean temple? Your temple is the body of the Holy Ghost. Your temple belongs to God. And he built my house so fast. And I told him he had to go live with his mama because he can't live with me. Because I'm not shaking, messing up my blessing. Hallelujah. So he got in a hurry. He went to Pastor DeLord's house. But Pastor DeLord was going out of town. So he went to Reverend Charlie Barfield's house. And Reverend Charlie Barfield came in, married us in our house. And I thank God for the word of God. For you, the Pastor DeLord. To deliver the word that delivered me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So you single women, single mother, you're looking for a husband. It's in the word of God. Seek the word of God for direction. Because there are many divorces everywhere. Let God send you a godly man. One that's gonna love you. One that's gonna walk in the house of God with you. One that's gonna kneel and pray with you. One that's gonna hold your hand. And if you got one, make sure he loves his mother. Because when he loves his mother, he's gonna love the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. And as Jesus was on this earth about his father's business, Jesus said, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish his work. Jesus said, I came down from hell not to do my own will, but the will of the one that sent me. Then Jesus go on and said, I must work the work of him that sent me. While this day, no man can work. Then Jesus goes and said, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. And I'm talking about the will of my heavenly Father this morning. Jesus loved us so much that he did his will just because of us. And as Jesus, he went in the Garden of Gethsemane. And Jesus kneeled down and prayed 3 times. And Jesus said, oh, my Father, if it possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, as I will, but as thy will. And Jesus began to pray and pray. And God sent an angel down from heaven and strengthened Jesus. And Jesus prayed the more earnestly. And the Bible said Jesus prayed. His sweat would drop on the ground like great drops of blood. Yeah. But after he got that strength, Jesus knew he had to accomplish the mission what God had sent him to do. Yeah. And Jesus, as he went on about his father's business, he never gave up. And his mother Mary never gave up. She was there every step of the way. I'm talking about a mother that loved her child. A mother that would pray for her child. In spite of her child wrongdoing. A mother that would be there. That would not let her child go astray. But she would pray. She would pray. I'm talking about a praying mother. And Mary was there. As they led her son Jesus from hall to hall. Mary was there. And as she think about the things that were told to her by her son Jesus, as it pondered in her heart, she never forgot. Because she knows she had birthed the Messiah. The Messiah. The one that, hallelujah, the only way we could get to eternity is through Jesus Christ. And as they lied on Jesus, hallelujah, they found fault in Jesus. Just like they'll find fault in me and you, but it's all right. They did it to Jesus. We're no better than him. And as they spit on Jesus, they slapped him in his face. Hallelujah. Glory. And as he bare his own cross, y'all. Yeah. As he bare his own cross up, and God got the him just for you and just for me. See, we come bear that cross. But Jesus bare it. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah, Jesus. I'm talking about Jesus. God only begotten son that came down from 42 generations. To save old wretch like me. Yeah. Old wretch like you. Yeah. We ain't worthy, but thank God for his son Jesus. Yeah. I just said we are our fifth of rags. Hallelujah. Yeah. And that's Jesus went about bearing that cross, y'all. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. And as they lay him on that cross, y'all, they nailed him in the right hand. Yeah. They nailed him in the left hand. Yeah. They put nails in his feet. And they hung my Lord and Savior Jesus high. Yeah. They hung him high. Hallelujah. Yeah. Better than our pain. Yeah. Better than our burden. Yeah. Isaiah said he was wounded for our transgression. Yeah. He was bruised for our iniquity. Yeah. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. Yeah. And with his stripes, we are healed. Yeah. Whatever sickness you got this morning, claim you are healed by the blood of Jesus. Decree a thing and it shall be established. Just claim your healing. Walk in your healing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. And then Jesus hung there as he seen the people down there mocking him. And he saw his mother Mary. Hallelujah. She was there even to a cross. I'm talking about a mother. A loving mother. A mother that won't give up on a child. A mother. Hallelujah. I miss my mother so. Hallelujah. But I thank God for the time that I dealt with her. Even though I did my own things. Partying on the dance floor all night long. Hallelujah. And I had three children. How she took care of the children that took her on her wings and took care of her. I wouldn't holler. I was never home. But one night, about on the dance floor doing my own thing, I used to go home late in the midnight hours. So as I approached the house and I knocked on the door, and my mother, she got up and opened the door. And she was sitting in this recliner all night long, waiting till I get home. And it's part of my mind, my mama was sitting in that recliner. She was praying, Lord, send her child home. Hallelujah. I'm talking about a praying mother. I can pray for a child. Even if that child in jail or behind prison wall. Pray for that child. Don't give up on your children. Because same desire is swift and man's will. But I bind that in the name of Jesus. And I loose the blood of Jesus over every child that behind prison wall, jailhouse bar, in the street. I plead the blood of Jesus on them. Because how many know God never slumbers sleep? He's always watching over us. And the prayer of a righteous availeth much. And then Jesus hung there on that cross. Oh God, I thank you in the name of Jesus. As he hung there on that cross, hallelujah, in agony, in so much pain. Hallelujah. He had the sins of the world on his shoulder. But his heavenly Father had biked off for him. But God didn't leave him. Because Jesus had the sins on his word, on his shoulder. And God don't dwell in no unclean temple. God hates sins.
Yes,
you have to be holy with a pure heart.
Yeah.
And as Jesus hung there, he cried and said, my God, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Even Jesus felt forsaken.
Yeah.
Sometimes we feel forsaken, like God is not there. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
One time I felt forsaken.
All right.
I had to pray. I had to pray. Ask God, Lord, I need to hear you. I just need a touch from you, Jesus. I need you to breathe on me, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Elijah said it wasn't in an earthquake. Elijah said it wasn't in a fire. But Elijah said it was a small, still voice. Hallelujah. So you got to know the voice of the Lord for yourself. See, Satan got a voice too. But you got to know the voice of the Lord. And I was laying there in my bed one morning, and I heard this small, still voice say, Vasi. I said, Lord, I thank you. Because Jesus said, he'll never leave you nor forsake you. He'll be with you always until the end of the world. Hallelujah. That's what kind of person Jesus is. He won't talk about us. He won't lie on us. Hallelujah. But I come to tell you this morning, as he hung down that Calvary cross just for you and just for me. And as he looked down, he saw his mother, Mary, standing there.
Yeah.
And he looked and he saw his disciple, John, standing there.
Yeah.
And he said unto Mary, mother, behold thy son.
Right.
And he said unto his son, his disciple, John, John, behold thy mother.
Right.
Then Jesus said, I thirst. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
It was about finished. Then Jesus said, I thirst. Hallelujah. And Jesus, when he was on that cross, he said, Father, I commend thy spirit unto thee. And Jesus laid his head in the lock of his shoulder. And he gave up the ghost. Just for me and just for you. And it wasn't finished then. Joseph went to Pilate. And Joseph begged for Pilate's body. And Joseph buried Jesus' body in white linen in his own new tomb.
Yeah.
A tomb a man never laid in.
Yeah.
And that Jesus laid there, y'all.
Yeah.
I can think about it. My Lord and Savior laid there, y'all.
Yeah.
Just for us.
Yeah.
He laid there.
Yeah.
Just for us. Our disobedience. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Just for us. He laid there just for us.
Yeah.
And as he laid there,
yeah,
the grave couldn't hold him. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
The grave couldn't hold him. And as Jesus, he got up on that third Sunday morning with all power in his hand. All power. Resurrection. financial power, deliverance power, healing power, whatever you need this morning, it's all in the name of Jesus. It's all in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm talking about Jesus, Mary, baby, Joseph, the carpenter's son. I'm talking about Jesus, the Messiah. I'm talking about Jesus, the high priest. I'm talking about Jesus, the chief cornerstone. I'm talking about Jesus that loves us in spite of. I'm talking about Jesus that looked beyond our fault and saw our needs. I'm talking about Jesus, my bright and morning star. I'm talking about Jesus. Father, hallelujah, the will of our Heavenly Father, hallelujah.